Hey everyone, welcome back. Today we're going to be going over Masque Milano Russian Tea. This is my first fragrance from the Masque Milano house, and one that I thought when I looked at the notes I was going to like, and it's true, I do like it. I'll go ahead and read the notes to you. What I get, you can go to Fragranica if you want to read all the specific little notes. I'm just going to tell you what I got because I think that's what matters in the review. Tea, obviously. Leather, obviously. I got birch, I got mint, I got the little bit of raspberry, I got incense, I got some pepperiness, and I got kind of the white florals, labdanum, magnolia, immortelle, and there's some other little things in there. You can look in Fragranica if you want. Something interesting in there also that I'll talk about was there's something animalic in here. Anyways, on to the fragrance. When it first goes on my skin, I got the tea and I got the leather up front. They were the most forward notes to my nose. A stronger leather than I was anticipating. I wasn't anticipating it to be that strong of a leather. Something that kind of came to my mind was kind of like a Tuscan leather kind of leather. Something that also came to mind was something kind of reminiscent of like a zoologist kind of animalic leather, which I also wasn't expecting. I wasn't expecting to go so animalic. This is actually more animalic than you're led to believe, especially with the notes on Fragranica. I don't know if they've just chosen to leave that out or what, but absolutely something animalic in here. It's not pee or poopy, but it's kind of a musk. The tea, I mean, I'm not super hard. This is my first tea fragrance I've ever smelled, by the way. Another disclaimer. I have Zoologist Macaque, a sample that I still need to sample, and I'm aware that that's also a tea fragrance. I haven't smelled it yet. And as far as tea goes, I like tea. I like coffee more. But I definitely got it. I don't think it's very clear what kind of tea it is. It could be black. It could be green. It's just tea. I'm sure they use some kind of blend. It's very nice, and it subdues the leather because the leather is stronger than you're expecting, but there's a lot of actors working to kind of pull the leather more friendly, if that makes sense. So they have this crazy leather, but they have the notes kind of pulling them to baseline. I don't want to call this fragrance sweet because it's not sweet, but there are notes in here that sweeten it in a way. So it's not a sugary sweet, but you'll see what I mean. I mean the mint, and I mean the incense, and I mean the tea. It kind of sweetens the leather without a sugary sweet. It just makes it brighter, and it kind of adds that, I guess, natural sweetness to it, which I like. There's the raspberry in there too, and I know you're thinking like, oh, Tuscan leather. And it does have some Tuscan leather facets to it. That raspberry, it's not as bright and fruity as in Tuscan leather, that raspberry. This is more of a tart raspberry, kind of a sweet tart raspberry. But it is reminiscent of Tuscan leather. It's reminiscent of a lot of things. This is one of those fragrances that can, it reminds you of a lot. The tea, when you smell it from the sprayer, the tea is a lot more prominent, but once it goes on your skin, it's a lot more leather prominent. It's kind of this dual polar 180 degrees shift, because when you first smell from the spray, you're thinking you're gonna get a ton of tea, but once it hits your skin, that leather pops. I think the florals are nice. How it dries down, it dries down where the leather isn't so prominent, the leather falls off, which is interesting, a leather top note, okay, but that's kind of what happens, because what I'm left with is kind of the floral. So it is weird, isn't it? It's like some kind of like weird polar opposite, like whereas the flowers are usually the top, the flowers are more the bottom here, which is really strange now that I think about it. I wasn't thinking about it until just now. I think the musk, somebody on Fragranica said it's a floral musk, if that makes sense. He said like a green musk. Like, what the heck is that? Does he mean like the green stemminess of the flowers? But it was a really interesting comment because I thought about it a little more. He said animalic, a floral animalic. And that's a really interesting concept, and I've never thought of that before. Like, can flowers have this animalic aspect to them? I don't know if they're fermented or what. It's on my fingers now. Yeah, it is strange. It has this musky base that could be attributed to something animalic, like animal, or something green and organic, I guess. It is interesting. This fragrance is interesting, but it's not for me. And I guess that's my verdict, is I've enjoyed this sample. I'm enjoying it right now. But I don't need another leather in my collection. I've got enough leather. And, you know, leathers aren't, like, something you need a lot of. I feel like you have one or two that you like mine would be rhinoceros. I've also got Russian leather to try by memo. I've got a sample of that. And this is nice. I've got a bottle of Tango, Masque Milano Tango, that I really like. I'm excited to review it. Not reviewing it today. But this is all right. I would totally recommend it to somebody looking for a different leather. In a way, a fruity leather, a floral, herbal, spicy, sweet leather. It's a different take on it. Absolutely. I think it's innovative. It's not for me. I don't like it enough. The tea is nice, but I don't need to smell like tea all day. It's not a smell I want on me in the long term. It's something I enjoy for the novelty, but I don't need to smell like that. I don't think that's congruent to who I am. So that's not the direction I'm going to go fragrance wise. But I think it's a really interesting line. I'm excited to try more Masque Milano. I think they're strange scents, beautiful bottles. My Tango bottle is so beautiful. So I'm excited to review that. Anyways, that's enough to say about this. That's all I've got to say about it. Until next time, guys.